Big shout to the Ghosts and the Ghostettes. On this episode of Motorcycle Heavyweights, we talk about the bike builder, the legend, one percenter. Shout to the El Forestos MC. Today we talk about Tom Fugale and we get into it on this episode of Demons Row TV. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby. Big shout to the Ghosts and the Ghostettes. Welcome to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture, where we cover everything motorcycle club involved. I'm Sos the Ghost. I'm your host for the evening. And with great honor, I bring you a bike builder, a legend, a one percenter, somebody that contributed to this culture, somebody that was so great. They didn't even know, like, he was so great, he didn't even know he was great. You know, his wife had to explain to him, look, this is you in Japan, this is you in Sweden, they love you. It just shows that when you work hard and your heart is in something and you're a creator, like really like a god, like he's a motorcycle god, he's a creator. And it just brings me great honor to speak on people of this caliber, and I want to continue to bring light to the heavyweights of this culture, the legends. It's not just a club thing. Yes, the man is a founding father of a 1% club. Shout out to the El Forestos MC. But it's just everything about this man was great, and we're gonna break it down. But the first thing I want you to do, like we always do on this channel, is to hit me with that pound ghosting. And that lets me know you're alive and well, sitting on twos, doing what you do, or just part of the Demons Row community. One of my ghosts. Shout to all my new subscribers. Welcome to the row. Make sure you hit that bell so you get the notification. Hit the like button. We got the Motorcycle Heavyweight Tees out now. If you want to support the whole Motorcycle Heavyweight movement, the legends of this culture, follow our second page, the Sos the Ghost page, where we do all the riding, actually out on the road, riding out there, talking about this culture. Follow us on Instagram at Demons Row, at Sos the Ghost underscore, and let's get into it. So the first thing that I want to say about Tom Fugale, before we get into the logistics, birth, death, all of that stuff, there was something that he said that really resonated with me as far as this culture goes. He said, anyone could buy a bike. He wasn't fascinated with the actual riding of the bike. He was fascinated with the creation of the chopper. And his club, the El Forestos MC 1%, much respect to them. You can't even get in there miss if you don't got a souped up, chopped up bike that is a creation. And I really like the creative aspect of what they're all about. Big shout to them. That's what this culture is supposed to be about. You know, creativity, being yourself, not caring what anybody else thinks. That's what this culture is about. The man wanted to be so precise with his work and so different from everybody else. He would create his own paint. Like he would create his actual own paint so it would shine a certain way, or you know, whatever way he wanted to maneuver it. And I just love creativity. So it says Thomas Jerome Tom Fugale, born 1941 in Sioux City, was an American craftsman and legendary biker. Tom was the son of Salmer and Bernadine Fugale. Tom graduated from Central High School in Sioux City. He married Connie Anderson in 1969, and together they had a daughter, Natasha. Connie and Tom later divorced. Tom started dating Janice DeCora on July 4th, 1998, and they got married on October 23rd, 2016. Tom Fugale is one of the founders and the undisputed president of the El Forestos Motorcycle Club. Fugale bought his first chopper in 1961 after buying a Harley-Davidson Dresser with 3,000 miles on it for $800. $800. Imagine if we could get Harleys now for that price. He later said it was the most money he ever paid for a motorcycle. Wow. $800 is the most that a legend of our culture had to pay, and that just shows you how much the dollar bill has lost its value in America in this day and age, because $800 was a lot of money at that time. His last bike was the Evolution Chopper. There are two documentaries featuring Tom Fugale. 21 Days Under the Sun came out in May 2016 on Netflix. Another by Jesse James called The History of the Chopper. The 8-minute documentary EFMC depicts the rituals of the El Forresto Motorcycle Club in the late 60s. And there's a clip right now that I want to share some words from Tom Fugale. And he's talking about being born with it or not. Like, some people, I was talking about this in a video that I did a couple of days ago. Some people just have that it factor. Some people just, you know, like, you could teach anybody how to paint, but, you know, they're not going to be Leonardo da Vinci. You know what I mean? So he basically breaks that down. Let's run that clip real quick because I want his exact words said.
You know, it's like you're either born with it or you're not. You know, I don't know why, but you either got that talent or you don't have it. I mean, you know, you can show somebody how to use a paintbrush, but you can't teach them how to paint a picture. The fact that I had to fucking get this bike done, I just kept working on this because I wanted to keep my word on that I was going to be there, and I knew what I had to do.
And what I love about this clip, where he says whether you're born with it or not, I think this is a learning lesson for everybody. Like, he did what he loved, what he was great at. You have to find your niche. You have to be true to yourself and what works for you. If he would have turned around and said, you know what, I want to be a basketball player, and I want, you know, I'm only a certain height, whatever his height was, I want to be a basketball player. And he just kept on and on and on and never made it to the league. No, he did what he felt in his heart. And that's what I feel a lot of people have to do. I believe that everybody has some type of purpose. Some purposes are higher than the other, or people just neglect it. I don't know what your belief system is, but I believe that a lot of people are not real with their self, and they chase a dream that they see it's not working, and they don't learn from it and say, what did I learn from this? All right, let me do this now, because I did so at that, I didn't do great. But if I take this and go somewhere else with it, I could be great at that. And I love what he said, and it's a testament to hard work over talent. When he was building the bike for the Born Free show, and he was already up there in age, and, you know, he told his wife, like, he doesn't know if, like, he's gonna be able to live through finishing the bike because of his age. She was telling him, don't kill yourself over it. I'd rather have you than the bike. But Tom was such a legend that he had to put his legendary work out there. Like, that, to me, that's like, it's such a beautiful thing. Like, if you really think about it, how serious some of us take our craft. People like Tom were an inspiration. He was around the legendary David Mann. They founded the El Forestos together. National president. Check out the video I did too, the Motorcycle Heavyweights, where I featured David Mann from Easy Riders magazine, El Forresto MC 1%. It's a great episode, and I really enjoy featuring the legends like this. Tom was self-employed most of his life, running a print shop and also selling leather accessories. Tom co-founded the El Forresto's Motorcycle Club in 1962 and was very involved with the MC. He built choppers and was sent all over the world to build choppers for customers requesting him. So unfortunately, we lost Tom in 2016, December 18, 2016. A true legend, a true motorcycle heavyweight. And one thing I gotta say about his life, and I think that we could learn from his life, and I learned it in my life too. Sometimes you get depressed, sometimes you get down, and you don't know why. It's because some of us are creators. Some people think that it's tied to finances or relationships. True happiness, I don't feel, is based on your relationship with someone else. I believe that true happiness is your relationship with yourself. And when you're a creator, when you're a creative, you feel unhappy when you're not creating. That's why I say he's a motorcycle god, because he was a creator. He didn't feel right. And this is why he lived life to the fullest, because at the age of 75, he's still trying to, like, you know, build these bikes and everything to his dying day. And that's what it's all about. and that's why he'll go down as a legend. I don't know if you ever seen the movie Troy, but one of my favorite sayings ever was when the little kid went to wake up Achilles, because there was, you know, he had to fight this huge warrior, and the kid says, "I would never want to fight that man. He was the biggest man I ever seen." And Brad Pitt looks at him, Achilles, and he says, "That's why they won't remember your name." And that is so deep to me. Like, it's like the things that nobody wants to do, when you do those things, that's when you hit that legendary status. So rest in peace to the legendary Thomas Fugale. And I just want to say that me personally and my experiences, when I was not creating, before I started Demons Row, I was a very unhappy person. And I never understood why. Why am I so unhappy? And I realized the only time I'm happy is when I'm creating. So that's why Demons Row is such a blessing. Having this community and these great people, really great people. I'm telling you, I grew up in the Bronx around the grimiest of the grimy. There are some great people in MC culture, motorcycle culture, motorcycle club culture, whatever you want to break it down. There's some really great people. And I'm telling you, embrace the fact that you have great people around you. And if you have negative people around you, get them away from you immediately. Because there are great people in this culture like Thomas Fugale. Much respect to everybody out there. Let me know in the comments if there's someone that you feel should be a motorcycle heavyweight. And if you think that person is a motorcycle heavyweight, me being younger, there's a lot of people that I'm just learning about now. So give me the knowledge. We all give each other knowledge on this show. That's why I hate when people speak down on the show, because it's exchange of knowledge. We exchange knowledge with each other. I learn from you guys every day. So if you got some knowledge on somebody that is a great in this culture, hit me at demonsrow@gmail.com and give me the write-up. Give me the homework. That's what I've been telling people in the comments. Give me some homework. Send me a write-up. Send me some video clips that I could use, that I could clip out, and really give the people that deserve the flowers, the people that inspire others to ride. That's what this is about. How many people did Thomas Fugale inspire to jump on tools? And that's my mission in life, to get people out of the gangs and get them on tools, doing what they do, part of the Demons Row community, one of my ghosts. Big shout to everybody out there. If you want to support the show, get your Demons Row clothing now at www.demonsrow.com. And thank you for tuning in to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture. Like, subscribe, and comment. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby.